Hi friends, good evening. This is one of the historical concepts which we people must be aware about, because 20 soldiers have sacrificed their life for us, and how many soldiers would do it and how many would be injured, I don't know. But history we must be aware about, only then we would know the present situation and what would be the future situation. Okay, in order to get back to the present situation, we have to check back the history, which we have to go back to 1865, where William Johnson had drawn the border line for our country. Okay, even the Chinese government was accepting it, but 1899 another line was drawn, so it was McMahon line. Okay, all these details you can be seen through this map, so that you can understand what I'm exactly talking about. So the problem arises during 1950 itself. So during 1947, during our Independence Day, Jawaharlal Nehru was the ruler. Pakistan had an issue on this Kashmir and even this China. Akshay Chin, the important place, had this problem, because this particular issue is because of this Akshay Chin, which is the part of Ladakh, the Ladakh problem, the exact problem which we are talking about, has arisen during 1950. And you know, 1950, China has started building a road. So they were building a road from Zhejiang, China to Tibet, so that they can take that Akshay Chin as their part. Okay, so 1947, even the king Hari Singh from Kashmir had said even India to take the rule of Kashmir, but Pakistan were not accepting it. So there were many war. We have been facing nearly one war with China, and we lost. That is on 1962. So on 1957 we missed it, and on 1962 the issue has started, because our Jawaharlal Nehru was believing China won't do anything like that. But the issue has started on 1962. The Great War of Indo-China War has begun, and we have lost the entire place. That is Akshay Chin, and the border was gone towards China, and you know, India was just losing that place. Okay, so right now 1967, India was coming back stronger. So before getting to the 1967, we have to understand the impact of 1962. Many soldiers lost their life, the both side of India and both side of China have lost their life, and you know this war was a period of 1 month, and people have been started revolting against Jawaharlal Nehru. If we had reacted on 1950, this issue won't be appearing even in this 2020, because only then he understood that his defense must be strong. And you know, 1967 Indochina war, definitely India was standing tall. It was like through the Nathuna Pass, that was in Sikkim. Okay, through the Sikkim they were trying to come over it, but our Indian soldier stood strong, so that they understood the template of Indian soldiers, the real power of Indian soldier. So after that, we had lot of war from 1971. We had nearly 4 wars with Pakistan, which includes even this Kargil, and even one war with China, that is 1962. After that, there is no serious war between these two strong countries. And it is really clear that Chinese soldiers are little much stronger than India. And so both of the political leaders were not wishing to create a war after 1962 or 1967 issue. There might be all these violating shootouts between all these LOCs, but there was no single war after this. Okay, but we were having a lot of wars between Pakistan, but not with China. So the present problem arises because of 2019. In 2019, we just occupied, Pakistan occupied Kashmir. That is Article 370. And the next plan was to occupy Akshay Chin, which was under the control of China right now, because the border of our Indian map, we have included it, okay. But it's already in the control of China, and right now, and that's the reason behind this, all these problems. In order to understand more, even though China is strongest country, but their geographical location is weak, and that's the reason behind they are occupying each and every place on and on, okay. In Tibet itself, the country is so weak, and that's the reason being even part of Tibet is controlled by China, because Tibet has lot of lakes around, and you know, in Tibet you have all this Himalaya and all your famous mountains are being there in Tibet. And here comes the most important, that is the present situation. June 6th, Chinese soldiers were coming towards Pangong Lake, and you have to exactly imagine that towards the history. In 1899, McMahon line was drawn. And in 1962, when they won us, they just came 20 kilometers more than the exact, that is the Galwan Valley. And they just occupied that line, because so that Indian soldiers can't go up toward their country and occupy their place, that is in Ladakh. And here the exact problem happened. And you know, and that's the reason behind there are a lot of shootouts were happening on this June 15th. And you have seen a loss of 20 soldiers and our opposite side 43 soldiers and lot of soldiers were injured, etc. And Galvan Valley played a vital role because through that way they can enter, Chinese soldier can enter Ladakh and get back the 20 kilometers which has been left in 1962. During that period itself, Jawaharlal Nehru didn't allow it because that is the soil of India. And you know, now the problem is that there is a marking, that is finger 1, finger 2, finger 3, finger 4, finger 5, finger 6, finger 7, finger 8. These places both Indian and Chinese soldier would go for rounds, etc. But right now through finger 4, through the lake of Pangong, Chinese have started constructing an infrastructure. That is the location where that does not belong to India. And you know, they are planning to occupy that particular 20 kilometer place. Okay. So in order to watch what India is doing, they had planned and made a watchtower there. And India had planned to build at two roads. And you know, Indian soldier was successful in building the first road, that is from Daulat Bagoldi to Darbuk Shayok. Okay, it is a 60 kilometer road and it's called as Bailey Bridge. Okay, so that they can move over the northern part, that is Sinsia Glacier, in order to see what is happening in Akshay Chin. Okay. So first road is complete, the second road is going on, that is from Sasoma to Sisarli. Even though this is a union territory, Ladakh, there are line of actual control in Sikkim, in Arunachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Himachal Pradesh, etc. You know, all this border, one side of Tibet, that is south part of Tibet, is on Arunachal Pradesh and northern side is in Ladakh. You know, Chinese soldiers are coming in, Indian soldiers are fighting. How many of them would lose their life? Everything, only God knows, because this is the actual problem right now. You know, India need to occupy the full part of Ladakh, that is including Akshay Chin. But Chinese need that Akshay Chin and little part of 20 kilometers which they left on 1962. So this is the one of the serious problem in our country right now. What one corner, another side you have Pakistan problem issue on board, and in middle of this many soldiers have sacrificed their life, they are injured. It's time for our country political leaders to talk with the opposite Chinese government and to treat with peace, etc., because we don't want war. What war would do year after, you can imagine it out. Already we are suffering from COVID, the whole world is suffering from COVID, and if there's a war, then that's it. So I wish all people must understand the seriousness of this Ladakh issue that is happening three decades it's happening, that is nearly for a 70 years war. So in order to understand it, you have to go through this history. Only then you can understand what would happen in future, whether Chinese would occupy or this India would occupy the full Ladakh or what exactly. You know, the entire thing would be solved in few months or few days, but the loss of soldier, no one can answer, right? So I want my friends to understand the seriousness of these soldiers and at least tribute them with a gesture when you meet them in your real life. Okay, I don't know how much it is. It's really a painful thing for their family to lose those 20 soldiers. And hereby I just end my video. Hope this video would be basic. I'm not any great speaker to make you understand with lot of graphic, etc. I'm doing with a normal cam with the rainy effect in my hometown, and you know, with the available map I would be explaining it out. So hope people would be understanding it generally. I don't want to be a teacher or a preacher to make you understand with lot of by telling lot of leaders names and lot of rules and regulations, etc. I've been explained with general things, and so that you can understand that what exact situation is happening in our country right now, even in this COVID period. So the great thing is that Indian soldiers are really strong enough right now, not like our 1962. From 1967, Indian soldiers are great and they are really double strong. So nothing to worry. We just need to stay strong. We need to pray for them. And let's see whether this solution is on or we would suffer, etc. Because if this is serious, I don't know, next generation people would really suffer a lot if there is a war, etc. Hope 1999 war, you remember about Kargil. We were these 90s kids, we were kids, we were not knowing about the seriousness. But if there is a war, I'm sure that it would be a nuclear war, etc., etc. I don't know how to imagine out. We need not think about it. Our Indian soldiers are there for us. and our PM is with us. So maximum, let's see what is happening. I don't know. I don't wish to see any soldiers getting into death, etc. Because a lot of things are happening a lot already with COVID. Okay. So once again, I thank each and every one of you for watching this video. I don't know how many of you would watch this video. I'm sure that you would get a general tip about what exactly is happening this many decades of years. Okay. So keep on supporting me. Have a nice day. Jai Hind.